people go.
Go down to yonder and there be ya, pack your things and go.
Go down to yonder and there
be. On December 17, 2016, a group of Southern Cameroonians rallied at the Minnesota State Capitol to make their voices heard in response to violent actions taken by the government of La Republique du Cameroon against common law lawyers in English-speaking Southern Cameroons. The lawyers were protesting against the imposition of French civil law in their English common law courts. This imposition is administered by French-speaking judges who have no background in English common law and little or no command of the English language. The lawyers' strike ran concurrently with a strike by teachers in the Southern Cameroons, protesting against the imposition of French-speaking teachers in English schools and universities in the Southern Cameroons. The situation made learning for English-speaking students difficult and sometimes impossible. The results have been undereducation for Southern Cameroon's children and poor performance in standardized testing.
When shall I see my lesson? I will never forget my home.
My home.
When shall I see my native land? I will never forget my home.
It did not take long for the teacher's strike and the lawyer's strike to gain sympathy from the general population in Southern Cameroons, who for a long time has complained that they have been marginalized in the UN forced union of La Republique du Cameroun and Southern Cameroon in 1961.
A minute of silence for those who have lost their lives that other Southern Cameroonians might live a life like human beings, not animals. So let's take that minute of silence for them.
Have come out today because of what is going on in our country. You guys have come out in this school because you believe that this struggle is what you have to stand up for. I am very proud of you. This is just the beginning. We'll be here every day or every time that we can make it. We'll plan more meetings like this to tell Minnesota and to tell the world what is happening in Southern Cameroon. The lawyers and the teachers and other trade union organizations in Cameroon have picked up this fight for us. This fight has been going on for a very long time. Now it is a time for us to finish it. You can see most of your placards that you have here. If Mr. Ambe can turn the camera around, you can see those who have been killed. And all of us standing here today is to support these people, to tell them that wherever they are, they did not die in vain. And I hope that the rest of Minnesota, those who could not make it today, they will hear those of you present here today and tell the rest of the world and tell Minnesota and tell the United Nations that it has unfinished business in the Southern Cameroons. The United Nations has a new Secretary General, and we will go to New York. We will go to New York and tell him there is unfinished business for the United Nations in Cameroon. Thank you guys for coming.
If you go find the way they hide the land for you, I will see how they send baccalaureate, make them write for you. We don't say even have 2 years, we don't go to school. And as they don't continue the key, we will one dialogue. We will talk say federation will be manageable. As there only should be no federation.
Separation.
That direct separation.
Separation.
You know something like this man will not be managed. I will get that kind of man never
come on. You
Stop.
I said, did you know your
Stop your two so.
They don't put light, they don't know say Ambazonia and they give voice.
So the message will pass across now say the strike never end. We'll just go and find some more resources we will reuse them. Some people will say for end of year message, maybe president will talk something. And no who be here. He no go ever talk say when I go. He will talk directly on that 31st. And when he talk on the 1st, when I know so wrong go we pass for street. Better will chop new year for street. And as we go to happen all over Anglophone Cameroon. And the good news now say the fight don't take over the whole world. Yeah. For all UN offices, I don't tell some Ambazonia and they sleep for them. May they know only go strike, go back, may them carry their mattress, carry their chop, chop for front, UN and British office, stay for them, wash for them, shit for them. Don't say they know to come out. Because the Britain and UN put me for the mess. And they will come back, move me for the mess. And as Honorable Weeper talked to Parliament the other day, if the chosen are going to win, may the period even shoot to the last man.
Yes.
Because we will continue for combat. And we will continue for resist.
When injustice becomes law, resistance becomes a duty. The people of West Cameroon have a duty to resist your oppression. There are two Cameroons that came together. If you are telling us, like a state minister stood here last year and told us that what happened in Cameroon is like dropping a few cubes of sugar into a basin of water. Who is the sugar and who is the water? I'm asking the government bench of Cameroon. Who is that you rape our children? My brother's daughter has been raped in Boya. I swear to you, the government of this country, does the president of this country know that the governors and the DOs and all the administrators you have sent to West Cameroon are out there behaving exactly like an army of occupation? If this is what you show us after 55 years, then those who are saying that we should break Cameroon are right. They are correct. The people of West Cameroon cannot be your slaves.
You cannot see what is happening in Cameroon. I don't care what you think. I don't care on which side you are in this debate, in this killing. You cannot see what is going on in Cameroon and not be totally appalled. Again, it is very, very cold out here, and we are still here just to demonstrate for Cameroon. And for what we are seeing on the pictures, it is just deplorable. The killing has to stop. The killing has to stop. And thank everybody again for coming out.
Hello, everyone. I stand here to look like a Southern Cameroonian. They always say the Southern Cameroon doesn't have a problem, but I think they do. Back in Cameroon when I was in school, I went to English Technical College, but behold, I wrote Pobatois in French. I had 3 subjects that were sent to us in French, and we don't speak French, I don't understand French, but we're forced to write in French. That makes some of us fail. A lot of people failed Pobatois because it is a French exam and it's sent to us English-speaking Cameroonians. So today I stand by saying English Cameroon has a problem. We had teachers that were sent from Yaoundé to come teach us in French. How can we be in an English school and we have teachers that are teaching us in French? The understanding is different, and when we go to the exam room, we've been asking questions in French. Even ORAs, we have ORAs, what is called practicals in the technical education, and we are the English-speaking part of Cameroon, but our ORAs is being coordinated in French. I was asked to explain in French, which I don't. I'm not fluent in French, but I was forced to. And most of us have been failed just because we cannot speak the language. And I want everybody here and everybody back home or wherever they are to stand on their feet and let's take this to another level. Because we cannot be forced to speak a language where it's not our culture. I cannot relate with anybody with that. Go back to the friend zone, tell them to speak English, nobody will respond to you. And English is not a compulsory subject in the French zone, but back home, Bamenda Boya, wherever they are, French is a compulsory subject. So we cannot keep doing that, we cannot keep failing. All our fallen heroes, the brothers and sisters that has lost their life for this fight, we want to tell them that we're behind them. Everybody is behind them. I will keep fighting. Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Woo!
My forefathers then tell me, say, no go Yaoundé. If you go Yaoundé, you go see something. My foremothers then tell me, say, no go for Yaoundé. We go Yaoundé, we see, don't see Pepe. Our daughters, our sisters, they turn them for pig inside mud. My brothers, are you human beings or are you human beings?
We are human beings.
Do you have the same rights as all human beings have or don't you?
We do!
We have one question that we need to ask ourselves. Southern Cameroonians, are you human beings or are you pigs?
We are human beings!
Do you feel that you have the power to protect your sisters or your brothers? Do you feel that you can protect your sisters or your brothers? As everybody has that right, do you?
Yes,
we do.
Southern Cameroonians, our grandparents tell us, no go Yaoundé. You go Yaoundé, you go see something. Will you see Pepe? Are we Pepe or are we Coco?
Pepe!
Will we be Pepe?
Find out.
So we'll come be Pepe. We'll therefore become Pepe.
Hello everybody.
Hello.
I'm grateful because we have come here together to join forces with our brothers and sisters all over to fight for the independence of our Southern Cameroon state. We are no more fighting for ministerial posts like ministries of finance. We don't want those posts anymore. We want a sovereign state, and it's high time we move forward. Good. We have come to this Congress that we should join forces. The American people should hear us. Because this is the means that we have. This is our own means to join. This is our own contribution we can give to our fallen brothers, those who have died for us. We are not only fighting for today, but we are fighting for our generation to come. Foncha and the rest, they started the fight, and we have to finish the fight. And the time is now. The time is?
Now!
The time is?
Now!
So I want to let you guys know that there are so many forces involved in this whole thing, both physically and spiritually. While we are fighting, I want us to pray to God because only Him alone can deliver us from this whole situation. And Bia thinks he's a very wise person. I just want him wherever he is, he might not be listening, but if he can listen, he's not different from President Mobutu. He's not different from Taylor in Liberia. He's not different from all these presidents that died, and when they died, they were so worried about their families. They were worried that what is going to happen to my kids? What is going to happen to my wife? Because we are going to go after them. They have to give us everything that they stole from us. They have to give us everything that they seized from us. That is why we are here today under the call. I wasn't feeling too well, but I decided to come out because this is not a one fight. This is everybody has to be involved. And I want to pray for those who lost their life because of this. I want to wish their family sympathy and tell them that we are here, we are praying for them, even though we cannot get to Cameroon, but we are trying to see if the UNO can intercede on their behalf. Thank you.
Cameroon will be welcome with two hands. But did they welcome us? Not at all. History has taught us one thing, that when you extend a hand of greetings and it is not received, you better beat the dust off your shoes and turn your back. When the Southern Cameroonians asked
for independence in the 60s, the third option was taken off the table. Cameroonians, Southern Cameroonians had always had the wrong end of the deal. The United Nations had always treated us as if we were second-class citizens. First of all, we were termed the Banana Republic and treated as a surrogate of Nigeria. Then when we asked for independence, they said you can either join the Republic or join Nigeria, and that the third option is off the table. Who is the United Nations to tell us what we want? The United Nations is supposed to protect the basic rights of the people, not tell them what they want. It has gone on long enough. We are here today not because we don't have things to do. We are standing up and saying, the country that has welcomed us, this country, the United States, that has welcomed us, had one basic thing. Its constitution starts with, we the people, can we, our brothers and sisters, can we back in what is now our home, say, we the people?
No.
Can we say, we the people?
No.
I want to hear you. Can we say, we the people in Cameroon?
No.
Because the very basic rights, the very freedoms that have made this country, that have made the Western world what it is, are taken away. Why should the police open fire? Look at the pictures around. Why should they open fire and shoot down people waving branches and asking just for dialogue? When somebody has been in power for more than 3 decades and believe that he is the only one who knows it all, there is something wrong with that.
Yes. A big problem.
There is something wrong with that.
Yep. Right.
Yes. My brothers and sisters, have you heard the gentleman be here? Has he made a single statement either to say, hello, I am mourning for the dead of those who were killed?
No.
This is just basic decency. Basic decency.
Because we're
it
not
calls for somebody to stand up and say, hello, somebody died. It doesn't matter your political aspirations. It doesn't matter what you believe in. It is just human decency. As that, when somebody dies, by the very fact that we are African, we are human beings, decency says we should speak up. Decency says, let us imagine for 1 second that the police that shot down and raped students acted on their own. Then what should the leader do? You stand up and say, no, that should not happen.
Right.
Justice must prevail. Justice must prevail.
The phrase don't want him to say anything.
Let us march for justice. Let us stand up for freedoms. Let us stand up for basic human rights.
Right.
Yes.
This fight is only the beginning.
Yep.
Because the justice that we've been denied for so long must come.
Yes.
It must come.
Yes.
It must come.
Yes.
Can I hear you say yes to that, please?
Yes.
Justice must prevail.
Yes.
We are one people. We are not to be divided again.
Yes.
We are not servants. We are not just servants or not us. We are Southern Cameroonians.
Yes.
We are Southern Cameroonians.
Yes.
Can I hear you say that?
Yes. We are Southern Cameroonians.
Southern Cameroonians, and freedom will prevail. Human rights will prevail.
We are here as Southern Cameroonians and Southern Cameroonian sympathizers. We are not here as Northwest, Southwest, because that label was put upon us. We are here as Southern Cameroonians. That's one thing that we have to understand.
Absolutely.
And because of the label that they've placed on us as Northwest, Southwest, always been keeping us apart. I mean, this struggle from Abongshe right to Ekondo Titi, all of us are hurting. And we have to understand that this is something that all of us should stay as one people. The divide between amongst us, I mean, has not been helping us. The system itself in place has put us in this position. So I just want us to understand also that this struggle is something that is just the beginning. We have to really sacrifice for financially and physically.
Hey.
So this problem has its roots in Paris, where President Biya is presently residing. Please look around all the French, former French colonies, and you will agree with me that there has never been there have never been true freedom.
Never.
There have never been true freedom.
Yes. Never.
France did not leave Africa. France came to Africa to remain, and France has remained in Cameroon. Here is the deal. All the policies of Cameroon are made in France. President Biya gives his speeches from France. The Cameroonian economy is micromanaged from France.
Yeah.
The constitution of Cameroon is first approved in France before it is brought to Cameroon.
Yeah.
Who owns Sonora? Who owns our paracetamol? The French have got even the military bases in Cameroon. In fact, a French very junior officer is treated better than a Cameroonian colonel. That is why the French people are responsible for the problems. Every bullet fired and killed to insult on Southern Cameroonians, where does it come from?
From France.
The French are responsible. Look at these pictures. Look at these pictures. The military is controlled by the French. Biya has got no policy on himself. That is why the Southern Cameroonian problem is micromanaged by the French. At the time when Cameroonians were asking for Ujamaa, which means one people, the French wanted it to be the Southern Cameroonians becoming slaves of the Republic. Are we slaves or are we free people?
No, we are not free.
Are we slaves or are we free people?
We are free people.
That in the 21st century, the very basic rights, the very freedoms that make us a people are taken away. The right to even go out and march peacefully is taken away. Just because the French are supporting Biya. If the French were not behind him, he would have long gone. The elections are micromanaged from France.
Yeah.
Why is it that the common law, the very common law that guides our people, the common law that protects our culture, that protects our customary codes? I am standing here and I'm wearing this hat. I'm wearing this. I'm holding this to signify that the rule that the customary courts have in Southern Cameroonians is primordial. Yet the French want to come and subjugate that. They want to take away the common law and take away the customary courts.
Napoleonic law.
And bring in
Napoleonic
law.
My lips can't even talk.
How many constitutions are there in Cameroon? Who knows the number?
About four.
And the French continue to make Biya, actually manage him like a dog. Isn't Biya a dog?
Yes, he is.
He's being led by a leech. And who's holding the leech? The French. That is why we are saying no to the Republic, no to President Biya, no to the subjugation that he's brought on the people. No, 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 no.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
No, no, no.
Thank you. Thank you.
No, no,
no.
Today we are
saying enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Yes, the education of Southern Cameroonians must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Amen!
The laws of Southern Cameroonians must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Yes!
The leadership of Southern Cameroonians must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Yes!
The lives of Southern Cameroonians must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Yes! The land.
Our children's futures must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Yes!
The minerals.
The minerals of Southern Cameroonians must be in the hands of Southern Cameroonians.
Yes!
Can I hear amen to that?
Yes!
My brothers and my sisters, do we think that freedom is given or freedom is taken?
Freedom is taken.
Seized.
face.
Did we ever say that our destiny can be controlled by other people, not
no.
us?
No.
No.
If you decide, if somebody tell you that come, I want to organize a vote, and they organize that vote, and you go and vote, does it mean that you vote one time for the rest of your life, you never vote again?
No. No.
Are you voting to give your destiny and that I will never in my life control my own destiny?
No. No.
So how can they tell us that you have the right to vote to do this? And once you do it, that is it. No more vote, no more for your life again. You cannot control your destiny. Is that correct?
No.
Is that right?
No.
Do we accept that?
No.
All right. We don't accept it. So what are we going to do?
We're going to decide our destiny.
Fight!
A few years ago, the president of the United States stood up. The president said that the people of Libya has risen up against their leader. And that leader wants to kill them. Because that leader wants to kill them, we are going to drop weapons on the people to protect themselves. Do you have that same right?
Yes.
Yes, we do.
So if they can go to Libya and drop arms to the people that they should protect themselves against their leaders, don't you have that right?
We do.
So are you going to be afraid to say that I have the right to defend my sisters and my brothers and my land? Are you going to be afraid?
No. No.
So Southern Cameroonians, Cameroon people have their problems. I am not, if they want to deal with Paul Biya, they can deal with Paul Biya. He is a stooge of the French. Yeah. They have their problem. Their problem is not my problem. I have tried to solve their problem. We have died to solve their problem. From the SDF to what? We have died in the hundreds, in the thousands, to help solve their problem. Their problem is not our problem. Our problem is our home is under occupation.
Period.
Our home is under occupation. Yeah. We are tired of their fight. If they want their liberation from France, they should go and get it. But they should leave Southern Cameroon
and
the Southern Cameroonians. They should get out of our land because they have shown us what they think we are. When somebody get into your home and take your sister and your brother and look at mud and put them inside mud and roll them in mud and beat them with stick, what do they tell you?
You're not a part of us.
They tell you that you are not a human being.
You're not one of them.
And what are you going to do to tell them that you are a human being?
You fight back.
Our brothers have died. Blood has been spilled. And we, Southern Cameroonians, are a religious people. Our religion, our ancestral religion, calls upon us to always invoke our ancestors wherever we are and ask that they bless our endeavors. Today, we are calling on all the ancestors of Southern Cameroonians to look down upon the blood that has been spilled. And we are asking them today that as we are standing on this ground is home. This is Southern Cameroon. When we are gathered right now like this is Southern Cameroon. And we believe that our ancestors are here right now.
Amen.
Look at this.
That the blood that has been spilled should not go in vain.
Amen. Amen.
We are asking that they bless this fight, that they hold the hands of our brothers and sisters that have gone ahead, that they take them and put them close to Nyumbom, close to Tarak, where you, close to all our gods, and tell them that these are their sons. They were fighting a good fight.
Amen.
And that they should receive eternal blessings in wherever they are, in heaven. Because our ancestors, you have never let us down. Let this cold that we're experiencing today, let this fight
be blessed as you have always blessed us. Because if none of you, the blessings from our ancestors, we will not even be in this country. Because we are here right now, we are saying, bless us. Let us be together as one people and unite so that this should never happen again.
Amen.
This
Amen.
Should never happen again.
Amen.
That whoever raises a spear to strike any one of our brothers and sisters, to strike any one of us, that spear should turn around
Amen.
And strike them.
Amen.
That gun should not fire. If we were to fire, that bullet should turn around and
Amen.
Strike and strike them on the head. Because our ancestors
will all come back to them.
May you continue to bless us and bless our families and protect the lives of our loved ones back home.
Freedom,
oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
Tell them Cameroonians, oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
Let's fight.
How many flames for our government will keep? Oh, never be retired! Oh, never be retired! Oh, never be retired! How many flames for our government will keep? How many people have been working? How many people have been retired?